I've been using magnesium L-threonate on and off for the past few years, and while I'm not personally convinced that the benefits would be effective for the everyday person, you're gonna learn in this video whether or not this supplement may be useful for yourself. Hey there, everyone, this is Michael Dougal. I review Nootropics, and if you'd like to see more informative videos like this one, make sure to click subscribe. And magnesium L-threonate, it pretty much came on the scenes within the past few years, and that's because of the fact that it can potentially cross the blood-brain barrier more effectively than other forms of magnesium. And what this means is that it may help you think clear, it may help you with your energy levels, it could potentially help with sleep, help with alertness, pretty much all the things that you would need your cognitive resources to do. And before going in detail about magnesium L-threonate, what's important for you to know is that only 1% of magnesium is found in your blood, while 60% is actually found in your bones and 39% is found in your cells. And because of this, it's very difficult for you to tell whether or not you're low in magnesium. Of course, there are some of the symptoms, but if you were to do a blood test, it wouldn't necessarily show low magnesium levels, and they're still working on testing this method, because of course when it comes to supplements, often they'll only work if you're low on something. Like if you're low on vitamin B, then if you were to use a vitamin B supplement, within a couple of weeks you may notice you'll have more energy levels. So it makes it very difficult for you to understand whether or not you need the supplement. I personally never been much of a magnesium person before magnesium L-threonate. I had tried the different forms of magnesium thinking, okay, they may help me with sleep or anxiety, but they didn't really do that. So when magnesium L-threonate came on the scenes, I was super excited, thinking, wow, I can maybe have more restful sleep, I can have more energy, I can feel the benefits with respect to anxiety. And I would love to say that that happened, but with magnesium L-threonate, I've been a little bit disappointed in the use of it. And it's not necessarily the fact that it's not effective, it's very effective. It's just that it's a very costly product and it may not make sense for you to use it every single day. Like throughout the past few years, I've taken several cycles of magnesium L-threonate. I specifically like it when I'm on a calorie deficit, and being in a calorie deficit for me usually leads to worse sleep quality and also leads to irritability. And I've actually found that using magnesium L-threonate specifically during this period when I'm in a calorie deficit, my sleep is as good as it usually is. I'm able to get that restful sleep and I don't feel as irritable or as anxious as I typically do during a cut. So I find it a very useful tool that way. However, the rest of the time, say I'm not in a calorie deficit, I really don't notice that magnesium L-threonate doing too much for me. And the three main benefits that individuals would use magnesium L-threonate would be for their energy levels, it would be for reducing levels of anxiety, and it would be for improving sleep quality. And of the three, I would say that magnesium L-threonate can slightly help with your sleep. As a biohacker, I'm pretty big on tracking things like sleep as well as my fitness. So I've got my Ultrahuman ring, I've also got an Aura ring, and both of them do actually show improvements with respect to sleep quality when I'm using magnesium L-threonate. And I'd be using magnesium L-threonate every morning. I may use it in the evening. It just depends if I've used too many stimulants throughout the day, for example, and I may need help getting to bed. I would much rather use something like magnesium L-threonate over melatonin, and I find it pretty effective in those scenarios. And this is a fairly recent study that was done on magnesium L-threonate to determine whether or not it had benefits with respect to sleep. And what's interesting is that they actually used the Oura ring as a means of determining whether or not the sleep quality was better. And I personally like this because you see in a lot of sleep studies, they actually determine whether or not a supplement was effective based on subjective measures. But at least we've got some objective information here. We've even got a table, and what they were able to show was that there were actually significant improvements with respect to sleep when individuals were using a magnesium L-threonate. And this was a great study because they took 80 individuals aged between 35 to 55 years old, and they used 1 gram of magnesium L-threonate for 3 weeks straight. They also reported that they had a better mood, their anger was lower, their confusion was lower, and their esteem was higher. However, I've come across a lot of anecdotes where individuals mentioned that the sleep benefits were the exact same as other forms of magnesium. So why use magnesium L-threonate when it's just so much more expensive? So should you use magnesium L-threonate for sleep? Probably not, but if you're somebody that's tried everything else and those supplements haven't worked for you, then you may not lose anything by trying this supplement. And I've talked about some of my personal favorite supplements that I use for sleep and during this video over here, and I'm using those ones every single day. Magnesium L-threonate, I'll use it some of the time. Here's where things get interesting though, because they actually found magnesium L-threonate may be able to significantly decrease your brain age. And in this study here, they took 51 individuals between 50 to 70 years old. And what they did was measure things like their working memory, their executive function, how able they were able to switch tasks. And what had inspired the study was that they found that it was able to reverse cognitive decline in rats. So they put it to the test, see if it could help with humans as well. And they did find after 12 weeks that the brain age was actually 9 9 years less than what it should have been compared to the placebo group. And when I first came across the study, I thought it was nonsense, or I thought maybe it wasn't properly controlled. Although I'm very happy to say that this is actually not the only study, and we have another study which was done on a Chinese population that was aged between 18 to 65 years old. And it was a great study. They took 2 grams of magnesium L-threonate per day. And what they had found was, of course, the older the individual, as expected, the more likely they were to see the benefits of magnesium L-threonate with respect to anti-aging. And one of the best experts when it comes to neuroscience and anti-aging, Rhonda Patrick, has publicly mentioned that she's not the biggest fan of magnesium threonate.
There's a potential strong placebo effect as well. I don't think there's enough evidence to support that magnesium threonate is effective at improving sleep.
And this is completely reasonable because while the other forms of magnesium have perhaps hundreds, maybe even thousands of studies backing their evidence, magnesium L-threonate is still newer to the scene. There aren't many studies done on humans. There are plenty of studies done though on animals showing the effects with anti-aging. And now we're looking at anecdotes pretty much to determine whether or not it's practical for us. But with respect to side effects, magnesium L-threonate, just like the other forms of magnesium, it's pretty well tolerated. We saw that during the studies, we didn't have individuals that left the study midway because they weren't responding well to it. I also personally haven't noticed any side effects, but some of the ones you may want to be aware of could be drowsiness and fatigue. Headaches are somewhat common, as well as increased sensations of blood flow to the head. Sometimes I feel that with different supplements. And one of the most important side effects, or things you should be aware of when using this supplement, is that it may interact with other supplements that you may be taking, such as things that may have been advised by your general practitioners. So of course, with every supplement, make sure to run it by your general practitioner, make sure it's suitable for you. And if you're wondering how to start using magnesium L-threonate, you may want to consider using it at a serving size of 1 gram per day. And then if you do tolerate it well and feel like you may be better off using more of it, then of course you can increase your serving size up to 2 grams per day. You can consider splitting it up through the day. But what you should understand is that it's a pretty flexible supplement. Doesn't matter whether you take it in the morning or you take it in the evening. I personally prefer using it first thing in the morning versus in the evening. That's just me. I don't really like too many supplements before going to sleep. Although it shouldn't really matter much because for most individuals, magnesium L-threonate is not going to be stimulating. So it's not likely to keep you up. It's not likely to give you those energetic effects that you get from other supplements. And something yet to be determined is whether or not you should see a tolerance built when using magnesium L-threonate. As per this anecdote, they mentioned that it happened to them. For me, I don't personally notice it happening, but that's one of the things you want to be mindful of. And because of that, I would recommend that you use it in a fashion of perhaps 3 months on, followed by 1 month off. I might just use it 2 to 3 months during the year. That seems to work for me. I'd love to know your thoughts about the supplement in the comment section below. Do subscribe if you found the video informative, and if you want to chat with me one-on-one, you can of course message me on Patreon, and make sure to visit our Discord server where we have a 24/7 chat room where we're having a whole lot of fun. I thank you for your support and look forward to seeing you next time.